Men's Square, inspirational, motivational videos for the modern man.
Hello men, Saturday, 27th of July, 2019. First of all, a device for men that lets you emulate the, let's say, skills of your favorite adult movie star actress. Yes. Then briefly to the re-release of the Samsung Fold, because the first one was crap. Then on to dating at work. How many people have found love through dating their co-workers? And finally, Eddie Murphy's return to the stage. Stand up. But being how raw he was, will that even work anymore? So to our first story from menshealth.com, written by Zachary Zane again. Starts off by saying, let's be frank, addressing the chicken, as I will use as a safe term for YouTube. I'm sure you understand as a man what addressing the chicken means. You all have a male chicken, and when you're by yourself, many of you address it. Let's carry on. Let's be frank, addressing the chicken with your hands is passé. In 2019, we have the Autoblow 2XT, fleshlights, and lifetime silicone stroker. Which stimulates a BJ much better than your measly 10 fingers ever could. Technology, my god, let's carry on. The issue with these chicken sleeves is that they get boring after a while. Variety isn't just the spice of life, it's what makes for a great BJ. Indeed. Lucky for you, an emerging tech will allow you to sit back, relax, and within seconds, have a stimulated BJ from your favorite porn star sent straight to your chicken device. It's not called a chicken device, I'm just being safe for YouTube. But wow, technology. And it goes on to say, you can get these simulated BJs from renowned adult stars and amateurs from various countries around the world, including France, Japan, Brazil, and the United States. But what do you think of this? Is this technology gone too far? Is it mad? Are we reaching a point where real men dream of Android BJs? One has to wonder. Then we have this flipping thing right here. The FlexPie. The FlexPie is available right now and costs just $1,300. It's another flip phone that flips outwards, and this one's from Business Insider, written by Ben Gilbert. Personally, this FlexPie looks okay, but I think it's not really that good. But I want to focus on Samsung. And it says, in a single week, Samsung's ambitious $2,000 foldable smartphone went from being a fascinating, awe-inspiring gadget of the future to a disaster. And after months of delays, they've fixed it, supposedly. Then it goes on to say, though it still doesn't have an official release date, the latest report says Samsung could be ready to roll with a redesigned fold ahead of the holiday season. So October, November, maybe? I think the Galaxy Fold is cool. I actually like it. Too expensive, would never buy it, but I do like future technologies and I enjoy seeing new innovations. Then the next story from inc.com, and this one's by Melanie Curtin. I want to read this small portion from the article. According to one survey conducted by Career Builder, 38% of people have dated a coworker at some point. Another survey found that 14% of couples who met at work ended up getting married. Interesting. This outpaced the number of those who got married after being introduced by friends, 11%. So only 11% of people who met through friends, being introduced to each other through friends, got married in comparison to 14% that got married through meeting at work. Interesting. Then there's a brief list of the top 5 places people met where a relationship led to marriage. Number 5 is online. 4 is in college. 3, they were already friends, so she may have friend zoned you or you were an orbiter, whatever. That's only funny because it's sad. Then number 2 is through a friend. That's probably a bad friend. You know the saying, keep your friends close and your enemies closer? He bought you a crazy woman, didn't he? Seriously. And number 1 is through work. So basically, through work, people meeting at work is one of the most popular places people meet and get it on. But beyond just doing it is getting married as well. And it's quite easy to understand this one because working together, you see these people constantly. Many days out of the week, you're spending your time around and with these people. Then eventually, you want to get into some of these people. As things go, human beings. Put human beings anywhere together for a long enough time, eventually they'll start doing each other. But let's carry on. Finally, from the undefeated.com, Eddie Murphy returns to stand-up on Netflix. This article is written by, ironically, Keith Murphy, who I'm sure is no relation to Eddie Murphy himself. So Eddie Murphy, who in his prime in the 1980s was the funniest sentient being on earth, is set to return to the world of stand-up comedy. Murphy is close to signing a $70 million deal with Netflix for a series of comedy specials. $70 million, my god. That's impressive. More groupies on the way, more groupies on the way. The last time, from this article, Eddie Murphy did a stand-up stage appearance was in 1987. 32 years ago. 33 years next year. And many things have changed since then. Many things are more PC now, and Raw was called Raw for a reason. It was very raw. Many of his jokes would not work today. They would work. They would work, but they're just not savory today. They're a bit too much. So my harsh truth to this is, I'm not sure he would still be able to do what he did back then. Not even in doing it the same way, in terms of him being just as funny. We know he's a comedian, he can still tell jokes. But would he have material to shine in modern days and times? Would he? I hope so. But what do you think of this new device? Let's call this the headmaster, if you will. And what do you think of the new other device, the Samsung? Is it more folding crap? Overpriced? Yet still intriguing? And dating people you work with. Many of us have done so. Many of us have suffered the consequences. But what do you think of dating people you work with? And finally, do you think Eddie Murphy still has what it takes to make raw comedy? Can he make raw comedy anymore? But as always, focus, observe, remember. The world is yours. Have a nice day.